Welcome to Music Matters, episode 5. Wow, this is called a sax bone. Check it out. Oh yeah. Man, today's episode is gonna get weird. We're gonna really look at what is music and what isn't music. I don't know about this, but this is a lot of fun, I'll tell you that. Quarantine changes people. And now it is time for today's musical terms of the day. Today we have tonal, atonal, and aleatoric. Let's start with tonal. Tonal music is about 99.99% of the music that you listen to. Tonal music is what we play in band. It's what you hear on the radio. It's the song Happy Birthday. It's any song that stays within a key. It has a home base. Whether it's a major scale or a minor scale. Tonal music stays within some sort of centered pitch, and it makes it predictable. Now, atonal music, on the other hand, is the opposite of that. Atonal music lacks a tonal center. It doesn't have, you know, a do. It doesn't stay within a key. It feels much more random and unstable. And finally, we have aleatoric music. Aleatoric music is also known as chance music. Aleatoric music has some sort of element which the performer has to decide. For instance, play these notes for 10 seconds or improvise for 5 minutes. So any sort of music that is not the same every single time is aleatoric music. So aleatoric music could be tonal or atonal. But there is some sort of undecided or unstructured part of the piece. Like a small boat. It is now time for What Happened Today in Music History. And we have a special guest, folks, Mr. Johnson.
Hello, everybody. All of these events happened in the past on May 20th. In 1896, composer Clara Schumann passed away. In 1944, singer Joe Crocker was born in England. In 1946, singer and cultural icon Cher was born in El Centro, California. In 1954, Bill Haley and his Comets recorded their hit Rockin' Around the Clock. In 1957, Frank Sinatra recorded the song Witchcraft. In 1972, rapper Busta Rhymes was born. In 1989, Paula Abdul gets her second number one hit with Forever Your Girl. In 2009, Chris Allen wins Season 8 of American Idol, defeating Adam Lambert. Lambert is currently the frontman of the band Queen. And our musical history highlight of the day. In 1981, singer Rachel Platten was born in New York City. This is her hit, Fight Song.
All right, class, it is time for a quiz. Will you please label your papers 1 through 5? Your task is, are these excerpts music or are they not music? Here we go. Thank you. And that concludes our music quiz. Please turn your papers over, leave them on your desk. I'll correct them. We'll see how you did tomorrow.
And now it's time for I Bet You Didn't Know This in Music. That silly little quiz I had you do was just to get you to think about what is music and what is not music. Now, you may have thought none of those five were music, or maybe you thought, hey, all of those could be music, or somewhere in between. Well, let's just start with a simple Merriam-Webster dictionary definition of music, shall we? One definition is the science or art of ordering tones or sounds in succession, in combination, and in temporal relationships to produce a composition having unity and continuity. The secondary definition is vocal, instrumental, or mechanical sounds having rhythm, melody, or harmony. Now, I warned you that today's episode was going to be kind of weird. And let's be honest, it's already been a bit weird. But let's back up just a little bit here. Beethoven. Beethoven was huge, one of the biggest composers of all time. He bridged the classical to the Romantic era. And then the Romantic era of music led to so many magnificent pieces, everybody. And all of these composers wanted to be the next Beethoven. They added more instruments. They created new techniques. They created longer pieces with new musical ideas. It was just an explosion of art in the Romantic era. The Romantic era was in the 1800s, also known as the 19th century. But as the turn of the century came into the 20th century, or the 1900s, that is where some composers experimented even further. And this is where we have atonal music. Enter Arnold Schoenberg. Schoenberg was an Austrian-born composer, and he was opposed to the traditional romantic and classical styles of Europe. And he wrote a lot of atonal music. So again, that's music that is not in a key. The piece we have on right now is called Piero Lunaire, and as you can hear, it sounds all over the place. Schoenberg also developed a 12-tone technique, which was an influential compositional method which manipulated the series of all 12 notes in a chromatic scale. So he would use all 12 notes of the chromatic scale in a random order before he would repeat a note. And when you do that, you get some weird sounds. You thought that was weird. Oh, we're just getting started, folks. Enter John Cage, an American composer who really pushed the limits. Why, yes, I did try to find a terrifying photo of him. What you're hearing right now is one of his pieces for prepared piano. Yes, you heard that right, prepared piano. So he would put things in the piano. I'm not joking, like on the strings. He would put screws, bolts. He would put paper clips, straws, pencils, erasers, all sorts of things on the strings of the piano so they would muffle or choke the timbre of the sound produced by a key when it's pressed. Yep, this is one of his pieces for prepared piano. Yep, folks, John Cage, really, really weird and really pushing what music is. Obviously, those prepared piano pieces are atonal because they are definitely not in a key. Now, maybe his weirdest thing ever was 4 minutes and 33 seconds. That's the title. It's a three-movement composition. And the entire piece is just the orchestra sitting without playing for the entire duration. So the piece consists of the sounds of the environment that the listeners hear while it's performed. In the episode 5 listening guide, I linked a video of a live orchestra playing 4 minutes and 33 seconds. And I'm not joking. It's the weirdest thing you'll ever see in your life. Check it out. The audience actually claps at the end.
Now that you learned about all that, would you have changed any answers on your quiz? Could all of them have been music? Now that was a masterpiece. Best thing I've ever written. Thank you so much for being here for the premiere of Trapped in a Basement. All right, that wraps up episode 5. The weirdness is finally coming to an end. And I'm gonna change my tagline a little bit today. Go out there and listen to some weird music. Bye.